Okay, thank you very much, Professor Tanabe. I'm very happy to see all of you here, and very good afternoon. So today I'm going to give kind of a short overview, a very brief overview of Russian culture and science. And when you look at the first slide of my presentation, you see here three different addresses in different countries: China, Estonia, and Poland. And I put them, as I always kind of make jokes, in the alphabetical order, C, E, P, and yet no address from Russia. So then you may ask, why am I going to talk about Russian culture and science? Well, as you have heard, I was born in Russia, and I will also give kind of maybe a short brief self-introduction. So you have heard, I got my degrees long time back. I was much younger at the time in Russia and also in Poland. And now I have these positions, as you have heard, in Estonia, Poland, China. And yet, since I'm Russian, I still feel kind of no connection with Russia. Also, I spent almost nearly 19 years out of the country. So I would like to speak about Russian culture. Yeah. But before I start my lecture, let me also show you some places which I have seen so far, which I enjoyed to visit thanks to science and physics. So this is my home city somewhere here, close to Black Sea, city of Krasnodar, south of Russia. And I left it in October 2000, 17 years back, and I moved then to this small country in Africa, Eritrea, former colony of Italy, which is squeezed in between the Red Sea, Ethiopia, and Sudan. At that time, Sudan was not split yet into two countries. I spent there 1 year. After this, I moved to Israel, a very nice place, Rehovot, Weizmann Institute of Science, very well-known place. And after this, somehow the story changed, and I somehow moved to Far East, and I stayed in Japan for more than 4 beautiful years in Kyoto. And Professor Sawatanaka-sensei was my boss at that time. And I enjoyed life in Kyoto very much. Then I moved to Estonia, a small country in the north of Europe, in between Baltic Sea, Finland, and Russia here. And then, as you have heard now, I have these positions also in Poland and in China. And now, somehow, story comes back, and I'm now in Kyoto for 4 beautiful months. Well, maybe a few more slides about Estonia. So this country of Europe, a map of Europe, okay, a green color shows the EU countries, and the map is now somewhat out of date, and Britain is still shown as a EU member. Well, perhaps I would have to change the map now. So this dark green country is Estonia, as I said, Baltic Sea here, Finland over there, and here Russia. The most fastest route to travel from Estonia to Japan is you fly to Helsinki, a flight just about 25 minutes. Then you take a flight from Helsinki to Kansai Airport, about 9 hours. Well, so then this is the map of Estonia. A small country, really a very small country, as you see. Population is about 1.3 million, less than in the whole city of Kyoto. Area is also not very big. You can cross the whole country from north to south in about 3 hours by car. So, and Tartu, the city is somewhere here in this part of Estonia. So here we have a capital, Tallinn. And the next slide shows a few images from Tartu. So this is the main building of Tartu University. I have to go back, yes. It is pretty old one. It was founded in 1632 by Swedish king. So this is the main building in winter time, when we have this a lot of bright LEDs to light it up before Christmas. And in summertime, we also do have sometimes blue sky and warm weather. Yeah, so then also a few images of Tartu city here. So this is a main square and city hall here, main river which goes through the city. Some churches over there in winter time. Well, winter time here, it can be pretty cold, like minus 25 degrees Celsius, sometimes minus 30, so quite harsh winter. Yeah, and Tartu is a small town, population is about 100,000 only. But it is famous for its old university, which I work in. Yeah. Well, So before we start now actual lecture, I would like to give a quote, which is quite funny quote and quite famous in Russia. Nobody can embrace the unembraceable. And the person who is the author of this quote is Kuzma Prudkov, but it is a fictitious person. It was not a real person, it is kind of a pseudonym. And famous Russian writer from 19th century, Alexei Tolstoy, not Leo Tolstoy, but Alexei is a different Tolstoy, and his three cousins just wished to have fun, and they just somehow tried to write many kind of jokes, poems, under this kind of pseudonym. So nobody can embrace the unembraceable. Yeah? And why do I give here such a quote? Well, if we are going to speak about science and culture of Russia, and as of science and culture of any other country, it would mean really a very long lecture, maybe even a long lecture course, several years of tough and hard studies, like to get bachelor degree, master, PhD, and even then, many things would just remain untouched, definitely. So we have here only about 1 hour, and what I can give here, even if I would do my best what I am going to do, I can just give a very short introduction to some maybe aspects of life in Russia. And again, I have to tell you in advance, of course, this simply cannot be complete. I simply cannot give a full overview of everything.